Dios en la Erika.
Let us be in an attitude of prayer as we are listening to the Word of God. There is continual Word of God in our church. In all of our prayer meetings, we find time for the Word. There are four things that happen with the Word being spoken.
We will get certain information.
One, you can learn some history and some information about the Word of God.
We can
also receive instructions on what we are to do, how we are to go,
instructions.
Third, we will have inspirations in the way that we are walking in this world and will give us a time of comfort. But all of them combined together, the main point of the Word of God is to have spiritual transformation. And that is our prayer as we're in the Word. Not to receive just some information. Don't just think you got some instruction today.
I'm excited, I'm inspired by the Word of God.
Or not just to get some comfort and words of inspiration.
Oh,
we need to be in an attitude that I will change, transformed by the Word of God. For the last many weeks, we've been thinking on this series, The God of the Valleys. Until the Holy Spirit guides me, I will continue on this topic. Children of God is always looking forward to Zion. It is not just traveling on plain lands. In our spiritual journey, we will have hills and valleys in our travel.
Oh,
just as we have times of joy and times of sorrow, unexpectedly, we have times and experiences of valley. Even though we have hundreds of testimonies of how the Lord has victoriously led us, there will be one episode that tries to overtake all of them.
When
we are victorious and talking about our victories from the past, there will be a time of a defeat or a time of sorrow that comes in our life. But a true saint of God has the knowledge that God is with them, whether you're on the mountain top or you're in the valley. Our God is with us, helping us and guiding us in our highs and our lows. We've been studying that our God is still God in the valleys. You can see the recap of the last 5 weeks on the screen. In the valley of temptation, the Word of God and the Lord helps us to be victorious. In the valley of transplantation, when we are transplanted to another place, the Lord is with us to guide us in the midst of that change.
No matter how
how much of a saint you are, there will be times when there is valley of transgression that comes. But when you confess your sins and go back to the Lord, He will guide you victoriously. There will be valleys of trials and challenges that also come up that I cannot overcome myself. It is not by my plans or my might that I'm able to overcome, but the power of the Lord that I'm able to overcome when I'm facing
challenges.
Last week we were thinking about the valley of the shadow of death, and that we will be in a valley of death, but before that we need to find the Lord and reach the other
shore. IPC Hebrew and Facebook or YouTube below ningalkku ee sandeshangal kelkavunnathaanu.
If you have been following us, or if you have not, you have the opportunity to watch them on YouTube or Facebook of IPC Hebron. So this morning we're going to the sixth valley in the series. Psalms 84 verse
6.
We know that all the words that are being spoken are very familiar to all of us. But we are trying to see what the Lord has to teach us through these things. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a spring. The rain also covers it with pools, it says.
Valley of Tears.
Today we're thinking about the valley of tears. Psalms 84 is written by the sons of Korah. There are about 11 Psalms that are written by the sons of
Korah.
Everyone believes Psalms 43, even though it doesn't say it on the top, is also written by the sons of Korah. Who are these sons of Korah? We usually just read that on top, the title, the sons of Korah. They have a testimony, they have a history, and they are in the Old Testament.
Israel makkalude marubhu yathrayil palappolum kadannu varunna prashnangal onnayirunnu നേതൃത്വങ്ങൾക്ക് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ദൈവം ആക്കിവെച്ച നിയമങ്ങൾക്കും നിയമനങ്ങൾക്കും നേരെയുള്ള മനുഷ്യരുടെ കൂട്ടുകെട്ടുകളും പുറുപുറുപ്പുകളും.
In the wilderness journey of the Israelite people, they had experiences where they would question the leadership that the Lord had placed over them.
ഉടനെ ദൈവം അതിന് ശിക്ഷാവിധികളും നടപ്പാക്കിയിട്ടുണ്ട്.
And we know that God would punish them for doing such things.
അതിൽ പ്രസിദ്ധമായ പ്രധാനമായ ഒന്നായിരുന്നു കോരഹിന്റെ മത്സരം എന്ന പേരിൽ അറിയപ്പെടുന്ന ഒരു അശുദ്ധ അവിശുദ്ധ കൂട്ടുകെട്ട്.
And one of them is the group that was formed by Korah the father.
And pudhiya niyamathilum rebellion of Korah, Korahinte malsaram enna peril leganangalil adu prasidhamaanu.
In the New Testament as well, we see the rebellion of Korah is familiar to us.
Sangya pustakam 16 17 adhyayangalil ee charithram namakku vishadamayi kaanuvan kazhiyum.
In Numbers 16 and 17, the chapters, we can see the full history there.
Vishadamaya oru charithra padanathinu nammude munpil avasaram illa, nammalkku innu aavashyavum illa.
We will not go into a full historical context, and we don't have time for
that.
Before we get into our word, I wanted to show you some of the background. Korah was an important leader in the tribe of Levi.
In
Numbers 16 to 18, you can see what type of leadership he had.
He
had leadership position in the church, and he had many council members to help him. He also was the first cousin by blood to Moses.
When we
study the book of Exodus, chapter 6, verse
16 to 21, we see
that the names of the sons of Levi included Gershon, Kohath and Merari.
Adil Kahathinte putranmarayirunnu Amram, Izhar ennu rendu per.
So Amram and Izhar were the children of Kohath in the Levi tribe.
Adil Amraminte makkalanu namukkariyavunna Amraminteyum Yokabethinteyum makkalanu Mosheyum Aharonum.
And Amram and Jochebed's children are Moses and Aaron.
Kahathinte mattoru maganaya Izharinte maganayirunnu Korah.
One of the other sons of Kohath, Izhar, had Korah.
Appol Mosheyum Aharonum malaliya ee Korahinte sahon first cousin.
So Moses and Aaron, the leaders, were the first cousins with this
Korah. And
because their fathers were brothers, they were brotherly
cousins.
We see that Korah was not satisfied in the ministry that the Lord had given him. He was filled with jealousy and he pointed fingers at Aaron and wanted to take over the ministry. In Numbers chapter 16, we read that. We see that three important people from the Reubenites also joined Korah in this rebellion. Their name was Dathan, Abiram,
and Orab.
They also received the support of 250 leaders, the tribal leaders of the land.
Let me not
go into details as you might be familiar with
that. I urge
you to go back and read Numbers
16 and 17.
We know that Moses fell to the ground and started to cry when he saw this number 254 of them coming against their leadership. That is how a saint of God is always. When other people point their fingers in rebellion, a saint of God knows not to form another party but to fall to the ground and ask God for help. And that was the same as we heard in the English worship, the behavior of Christ. Oh, Jesus did not retaliate. He was, even though he was persecuted, and that same behavior trait needs to be in us. So Korah and the group were jealous, and that is how they are forming this
rebellion.
They were not satisfied with the calling and the ministry they had before the Lord.
It is
when you're not satisfied with yourself that you speak against
others. It
is because you're not satisfied in yourself that you start speaking about others. If you're satisfied in yourself, you're not worried about others. These are spiritual lessons we learn.
You don't
need to sit and pray about someone to know their behavior
traits. You
don't need to do any psychological tests to know
them. Oh,
from their talking, you can know what is in their heart.
Do
you know why Korah was so
brave?
He has the support of three of the Reubenites from the executive
committee.
And he has 250 leaders, the council members vote. But know a truth. The Lord does not work based upon the majority or having more people say what you're saying. The Lord will come down to stand against anyone that will rebel against his plan and his will. Let me cut it short and go forward. Oh, the Lord is breaking apart this group that is rebellious against the leadership of God. Oh, the world, the earth opened up and there was a great punishment that the world had never seen up to that point. We know that the earth opened up its mouth and swallowed them up together to this group that was rebelling. But we read something that is amazing. In Numbers 26, verse 10 and 11.
എന്നാൽ ഭൂമി വാവളർന്ന് കോരഹിനെയും കൂട്ടരെയും 250 പേരെയും വിഴുങ്ങിക്കളഞ്ഞു എന്നാൽ
And the earth opened its mouth and swallowed them up with Korah when their company died. And it says, all 250 men also died, but the children of Korah did not die. When the earth swallowed up everyone associated with this rebellion, we see some children that, from this family that was able to be saved. Oh, they might have ran to the throne of grace and they were able to be saved, we can imagine. So three brothers, the Korah sons, we read their names in Exodus chapter 6, we see that these are the three men that we know as the sons of Korah.
Azur, Elkanah, and Abiyasaph, and the moon bearana.
Their name is Azur, Elkanah, and Abiyah.
Ivarana, Sangirtanga, Talakatil, Koregabutramana, Sangirtanam, and the bear Ledumbol, Ariapat, and the moon bear.
These are the names of the sons of Korah that we see on top of the Psalms. Now pay attention closely. They became a song group that would worship the Lord in praise later on in life. When you study 2 Chronicles, you see that.
And it's chapter 20, verse 19.
20, verse 19.
യഹോശഫാത്ത് രാജാവിന്റെ കാലത്ത് കോരഗ് പുത്രന്മാരുടെ തലമുറകൾ
We see that at the time of Jehoshaphat, the sons of Korah became musicians.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, understand a truth this morning. Who does the Lord use for the building up of his kingdom? Only those who are not joining together in rebellion against the Lord, their generations can be used. We know that the sons knew from experience. You can understand it from the 12 Psalms they have written. Oh, we have been saved from the edge of death. Oh, we were under the bondage of heritage and sin from our forefathers and we were delivered. They would sing to the the Lord that would not devour them when everyone else was devoured by the earth.
അത്യുന്നതന്റെ വലങ്കരം അവർ അനുഭവിച്ചതുകൊണ്ട് എപ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങൾ ദൈവസന്നിധിയിൽ ചെല്ലുമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ ആകാംക്ഷ അവരുടെ അകത്തുണ്ടായി.
Oh, they would always have a desire in their heart to go into the presence of God.
ദൈവമക്കളെ അനുഭവമുള്ളവർക്കേ പാടാൻ പറ്റത്തുള്ളൂ.
Only those who have the testimony can sing.
നാം പാട്ട് അറിയാവുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് പാടുകയല്ല.
Just because we know the lyrics we don't sing.
വാക്യം അറിയാവുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് നാം പ്രസംഗിക്കുകയല്ല.
Just because we know the scripture we don't preach.
ആശയങ്ങളും ഭാഷകളും ഉള്ളതുകൊണ്ട് നാം എഴുതുകയല്ല.
Oh, because we have the language we do not write.
നാം പാടുന്നത് നാം പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നത് നാം പ്രസംഗിക്കുന്നത് നമുക്ക് അനുഭവമുള്ളതുകൊണ്ടാണ്.
Oh, we preach and we sing and we write because we have that experience, that testimony.
അനുഭവമുള്ളവരുടെ അകത്തുനിന്ന് ഈ ആരാധന പുറത്തു വരികയുള്ളൂ.
Oh, those who have gone through those trials can sing these songs.
എത്ര പേർക്ക് ഇന്ന് രാവിലെ സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്?
How many of you are happy this morning?
എന്റെ സ്തോത്ര സ്വരത്തിന്റെ പിന്നിൽ വെളിപ്പെട്ടു നിൽക്കുന്ന ചില ആത്മീയ അനുഭവങ്ങളുണ്ട്. അത് ഓർക്കും തോറും സ്നേഹം എന്നിൽ വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നേ.
Oh, there is a history behind my words and my praise, and when I think about it, my heart is overflowing.
അപ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഞാൻ ഒരു കാര്യം കൂടി ചേർത്തു പറയട്ടെ.
So let me add something to that.
വളരെ ഹൃദയവേദനയോട് കൂടിയാണ് ഞാൻ സംസാരിക്കുന്നത്.
I am speaking from sorrow.
ഹല്ലേലൂയ പിതാക്കന്മാരുടെ ഹല്ലേലൂയ സഭാരാഷ്ട്രീയത്തിൽ യൗവനക്കാരെ നിങ്ങൾ ദൈവീയത പങ്കുചേരരുത്.
Young people do not get involved in the politics of the forefathers.
ദൈവസഭയുടെ തലതാഴ്ത്തുന്ന ഹല്ലേലൂയ ജീർണിച്ച സഭാരാഷ്ട്രീയം സഭകളെയും സംഘടനകളെയും മുടിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്.
Oh, the politics in the church is destroying the churches and the organizations.
അനേക പ്രസ്ഥാനങ്ങൾ തകർന്നുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നു.
Many organizations are in debacle.
അനേക നല്ല പേരും പെരുമയും ഉണ്ടായിരുന്ന സഭകൾ ഛിന്നഭിന്നമായി കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നു.
Many churches that have good names are now being broken apart.
ദൈവസ്നേഹത്താൽ പിടിക്കപ്പെട്ട ആത്മാവിൽ ആരാധിക്കുവാൻ വിളിക്കപ്പെട്ടവർ ആലയത്തിനകത്ത് വന്ന് രാഷ്ട്രീയം കളിച്ചിട്ട് സഭ തകരുന്ന കാണുമ്പോൾ ഹൃദയം വേദന കൊണ്ട് തകരുകയാണ്.
Those who have been called and separated to worship the Lord in truth and in spirit, when they come into the church and play politics, my heart is filled with sorrow.
ഒരു പ്രസ്ഥാനം എന്ന നിലയിൽ, ലോക്കൽ സഭ എന്ന നിലയിലൊക്കെ നമുക്ക് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ജനാധിപത്യ രീതിയിലുള്ള തിരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പുകൾ ആവശ്യം തന്നെയാണ്.
As a church, in order to have a consensus, we might need to take a majority vote.
അതിന്റെ ചിട്ടയായി നടക്കുന്നതിന് കുഴപ്പമൊന്നുമില്ല.
Yes, there is no problem in going forward with that.
ഇന്ന് കാണുന്ന മത്സരബുദ്ധിയും അവരനെ ആക്ഷേപിക്കുന്ന കൂട്ടു സഹോദരനെ തേജോവധം ചെയ്യുന്ന പ്രചരണ രീതികളും ഒക്കെ ദൈവവചനത്തിന് ഘടകവിരുദ്ധമാണെന്ന് തിരിച്ചറിയണം.
But understand, when you are ridiculing or making fun or competing with your fellow brother and sister, that is against the word of God.
മോശയ്ക്കും അഹരോനും അവരുടെ ശുശ്രൂഷയ്ക്കും വിരോധമായി കൂട്ടുകെട്ട് ഉയർത്തിയ കോരഹിന്റെ പദ്ധതിയിൽ കൂട്ടുചേരാത്ത കോരഹ് പുത്രന്മാരെ പോലുള്ള യൗവനക്കാർ സഭയിൽ എഴുന്നേൽക്കട്ടെ.
Oh, I pray that let there Hallelujah. Be young people that will stand up like the sons of Korah and not get involved in the politics.
ഇന്ന് പകൽക്കാലം പെന്തക്കോസ്ത് പ്രസ്ഥാനത്തിലുള്ള യുവജനങ്ങൾ ഈ സന്ദേശം ഇന്നോ നാളെയോ എപ്പോഴെങ്കിലും നിങ്ങൾ ശ്രവിക്കുന്നുവെങ്കിൽ,
Oh, if the Pentecostal young people would hear this message.
നിങ്ങൾ IPC-യിലോ ചർച്ച് ഓഫ് ഗോഡിലോ അസംബ്ലീസ് ഓഫ് ഗോഡിലോ ഷാരോൺ ഫെലോഷിപ്പിലോ ന്യൂ ഇന്ത്യയിലോ ഏത് പെന്തക്കോസ്ത് പ്രസ്ഥാനത്തിലും ആകട്ടെ,
it doesn't matter what denomination you belong to,
ningal dive cheythu ee sabharashtriyathinte valayil kudungi pogarudhu.
Oh, do not get involved in the net of this political parties.
Devavadinathinte shishrushakana nilil ningal avadal aatmavil apekshikkunnu.
Oh, as a servant of God, let me tell you, in the spirit of God,
hallelujah, pidakanma rashtriyam kalikkunnengil avar kalichukollatte kunningale yavanakare ee kaalathengilum ee thalamurayilengilum idin oru full stop iduvan chila yavanakar sabhayil ezhunnelkatte.
Oh, let the forefathers do what they want, but young people, can we put a stop to this playing politics in the church?
നമുക്ക് പാട്ട് പാടണ്ടേ? കോരഹുത്രന്മാരെ പോലെ നമുക്ക് സങ്കീർത്തനങ്ങൾ ചൊല്ലണ്ടേ? നമുക്ക് ശുശ്രൂഷിക്കണ്ടേ? നമുക്ക് ആത്മാക്കളെ നേടണ്ടേ? മാൻ നൂർത്തോടലേക്ക് ചെല്ലുന്നത് പോലെ നമുക്കോടി ദൈവസന്നിധിയിൽ ചെല്ലണ്ടേ?
Oh, don't we want to worship Hallelujah. Like the sons of Korah? Don't we want to give him the praise? Don't we want to run to the water like the deer does?
ഇത്രയും പറഞ്ഞ ഞാൻ ആ ഭാഗം വിടുകയാണ്.
I'm saying that and closing that part.
84th സങ്കീർത്തനം ദൈവിക വിടുതലും കരുതലും അനുഭവിച്ച കോരഹ് പുത്രന്മാർ ദൈവ സാന്നിധ്യം വസിക്കുന്ന ദേവാലയത്തിന്റെ ശ്രേഷ്ഠത വിവരിക്കുകയാണ്.
Here the sons of Korah in Psalms 84 is describing the greatness of God's temple.
അവർ ആത്മാവിൽ പാടി ജനത്തെ മനസ്സിലാക്കി തരികയാണ് ദൈവാലയം ദൈവമക്കൾ കടന്നുവരുന്ന ആലയത്തിന്റെ ശ്രേഷ്ഠത എത്ര മനോഹരമാണ്.
They are writing and singing about how great is the place where God dwells, God's temple.
ദൈവമക്കളെ, നാം കടന്നുവരുന്ന ദൈവ സാന്നിധ്യമുള്ള ദേവാലയങ്ങൾ മനോഹരം തന്നെയാണ്.
Yes, it is true that the places we worship ship is beautiful and the presence of God is there.
കെട്ടിടത്തിന്റെ വലിപ്പവും ഇരിപ്പിടത്തിന്റെ സൗകര്യവും സൗണ്ട് ആൻഡ് ലൈറ്റിന്റെ ക്രമീകരണങ്ങളും ഒന്നുമല്ല.
It is not based on the seating or the sound or light. It is not the people standing in the pulpit.
Oh,
it is because we as the children of God who are the temple of God are here. That is why this place has the beauty. What makes the temples that we gather in beautiful, or what is it so special about it? Psalms 84 verse 1.
It's a place of great beauty. It is a
place of great beauty, it
says.
Oh, how lovely is your tabernacle, O Lord of hosts. Oh, for the last year we have not been able to gather as a whole family, as a church. There are many thoughts that have come up in the people that go to worship. We have come to a stage where people are comfortable worshiping from home. Yes, we are taking the precautions needed for the pandemic. And until we have the freedom, we will continue to do
that.
Oh, but for the people that were in Babel, that Jerusalem was not just a memory, they would be always looking forward to it. We know Daniel, even though he was living in Babylon, would have his windows open towards Jerusalem. Even though you are looking at a screen in worshiping the Lord, let us open our hearts with the zeal for the kingdom of God and the Lord himself. Parents, tell your children about what is the ministry of the Lord, what it is in means to serve the Lord.
You need to continually speak to our generation about the significance of coming together and worshiping in the house of the Lord.
So the young people do not lose touch in coming together. I urge the parents to tell them about the beauty of coming together in fellowship. Oh, continue to tell them about the greatness of gathering together as a fellowship in brotherly love. That is why Psalms 133 verse 1 says, behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. The beauty of our fellowship is the love that the brothers have for each other and the unity that we have. Second, what is it that makes God's temple great? Verse 2 says,
it's a place of desire and worship.
It is a place of desire and worship that gives us the urge to worship.
84 verse 2.
Oh, we can put our hearts together and we can have a time of worship. When we gather together to worship, oh, even if you're alone or in your in a group, do not be distracted. I believe 75% of the church is at home watching this service. There are many, many, many people outside of the church also watching. Even if you're at home, do not be forsaking the gathering. The same preparation you had before when you came to church here on Sunday, prepare your hearts and your body in such a way. Oh, this is a time that we can open up our hearts and our minds and worship the living God. That is why the sons of Korah said in Psalms 84, better than being at the evil place. What is the house of the wicked? The sons of Korah were willing to call wherever there is not the presence of God, wherever there was unrighteousness, evil. Let me tell you in this context, not about our church in particular. Oh, when the parents sit together, if anyone comes to visit, when there's a phone call, oh, what the parents and everyone that is coming is saying. Are you talking about the faults of the others, the pastors and others? So the sons of Korah is saying, oh, better than living in the tent of the wicked.
Rather than being in the cullel house of the evil people, I would like to be as a standing as a watchman at the door place of the temple of God.
I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than live in the tent of the wicked.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
I'm not saying that all of our children are eager to come to church. We need to create that atmosphere in worship. Why are we speaking so heartily about our temple? In verse 3,
it's a place of nesting and sacrifice.
It is a place of nesting and sacrifice. What do we read there? Even the sparrow has found a home and the swallow a nest for herself. It is a word that is an
allegory.
In the Bible, these two birds are the most forsaken birds. The Bible talks about how cheap they are. They are not very expensive. Other birds make noises for the time. They are the most despised. But even for them, the temple of God is a place of refuge. Even though there is nobody to look after the young, I thank the Lord for the parents who realize that the church is a place for our young people to nest and grow up. Understand this in your spirit, parents.
They are getting more wisdom and knowledge in the house of God.
Oh, no matter what degrees, higher Hallelujah. Learning they might be getting, they get more wisdom in the house of the Lord. Oh, they will learn about life in the temple of God. They will learn about what is spiritual life in the church. Even though we don't gather as a group, parents, you need to encourage your children to join the Bible study, Sunday school, and different meetings that are going on. Don't allow them to get lackadaisical. I thank the Lord for all the gadgets you give them. Oh, but in the spiritual matters, they need to be zealous as well. Yes, let them learn the word of God. Let them grow in the spiritual life. Oh, let them be filled with grace. Let them be useful for the kingdom of God and the church of God. Oh,
ഉണർവെന്ന തിരിച്ചറിവ് നമുക്കുണ്ടാകണം.
Oh, understand that the church of God is a place for them to grow.
484 സംഗീതം 45 വാക്യങ്ങൾ.
In verse 4 and 5 we see something else.
It's a place of strength and blessing. ബലത്തിന്റെയും അനുഗ്രഹത്തിന്റെയും സ്ഥലം ആ ദൈവാലയങ്ങൾ ദൈവമക്കളുടെ കൂടിവരവുകൾ.
Oh, the temple of God is a place of strength and blessings.
എന്താണ് നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ വായിക്കുന്നത്?
What do we read there?
നിന്റെ ആലയത്തിൽ വസിക്കുന്നവർ ഭാഗ്യവാന്മാരാണ്. അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടവരാണ്.
Blessed are those who dwell in your house.
അവരുടെ ഉള്ളിൽ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ പ്രത്യേക ബലവും കരുത്തും ഉണ്ട്.
Oh, they have a special strength in their heart.
അങ്ങനെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടു ബലമുള്ള കരുത്തുള്ള ദൈവമക്കളുടെ ഒരു യാത്രയിലേക്ക് നാം വരികയാണ്.
So we are coming into a travel of people of God that are filled with strength.
ആ യാത്ര സിയോനിലേക്കുള്ള പെരുവഴിയാണ്.
Oh, that is the road to Zion.
അത് മോക്ഷയാത്രയാണ്.
Oh, that is a victorious salvation walk.
അത് വിശ്വാസയാത്രയാണ്.
Oh, that is a faith walk.
തങ്ങൾ അന്യരാണ് പരദേശികളാണ് എന്ന് ഏറ്റുചൊല്ലിക്കൊണ്ട് തിടുക്കത്തോടെ മുന്നോട്ട് പോകുന്ന യാത്രയാണ്.
It is a travel claiming that we are pilgrims and sojourners on this land.
അങ്ങനെ സിയോൻ യാത്ര ചെയ്യുന്നവരുടെ വിശ്വാസയാത്രയിൽ വന്നു കയറുന്ന ഒരു താഴ്വരയാണ് കണ്ണുനീർ താഴ്വര.
So children of God, as they're going forward in strength, one of the valleys that comes up is the valley of tears.
ഞാൻ ഇത് പറഞ്ഞു വന്നതിന്റെ സാഹചര്യം അതാണ്.
This is the background behind it.
നിങ്ങൾ പാപികളും അധർമ്മികളും ആയതുകൊണ്ടല്ല വൈഷമ്യമേടുകൾ ജീവിതത്തിൽ കടന്നു വന്നത്.
It is not because you are sinners and walking wayward that there is a valley of tears.
നിങ്ങൾ ദൈവവഴി വിട്ടു പോയതുകൊണ്ടല്ല ഈ താഴ്വരയിൽ നിങ്ങൾ ചെന്നുപെട്ടത്.
It is not because you have let go of the word of God that you have come to this place.
ആ വചനം വായിക്ക് the steps of righteous man are ordered of God. നീതിമാന്റെ വഴികളൊക്കെയും ദൈവം സ്ഥിരപ്പെടുത്തിയതാണ്.
The steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord.
അമ്മയുടെ ഉദരം മുതൽ നിങ്ങളെ കണ്ട ദൈവം.
The Lord who saw you in your mother's womb.
നിത്യതയുടെ തുറമുഖത്ത് നിങ്ങൾ നടന്നെത്തുന്നതുവരെ നിങ്ങളെ കണ്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ദൈവം.
The Lord who sees us until we take that step into eternity.
നിങ്ങളുടെ ജീവിതത്തിലെ ഉയർച്ചകളും താഴ്ചകളും കുന്നുകളും മലകളും എല്ലാം ദൈവം ക്രമീകരിച്ചതാണ്.
The Lord is the one who has prepared the mountain top and the valley experience for you.
അതേ സിയോൻ യാത്രക്കാരന്റെ വഴിയിൽ വന്നുപെടുന്ന ഒരു താഴ്വരയാണ് 84ാം സങ്കീർത്തനം 6ാം വാക്യം. ആറാമത്തെ താഴ്വര വാലി ഓഫ് ബാക്ക ഓർ വാലി ഓഫ് ടിയേഴ്സ് കണ്ണുനീർ താഴ്വര.
So in our pilgrimage to Zion, each and every one of us will go through a valley of tears or a valley of Baka.
ഉടനുള്ള നിമിഷങ്ങൾ വേഗം നമുക്ക് ഈ ഭാഗത്തിലേക്ക് ഓടി നമ്മുടെ കണ്ണുകളെ ഓടിക്കാം.
Let us go into that portion next.
ഭക്തന്മാരുടെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ അപ്രതീക്ഷിതമായി കടന്നുവരുന്ന കണ്ണുനീരിന്റെ വേദനയുടെയും നിരാശയുടെയും അനുഭവങ്ങൾ.
The saints of God will unexpectedly go through a valley of Baka or weeping.
ഇതിന്റെ മൂലഭാഷയിലെല്ലാം അർത്ഥം ഇങ്ങനെ എഴുതിയിരിക്കുന്നത് വാലി ഓഫ് ബാക്ക എന്നാണ്.
Oh, the meaning of this place is Baka.
ഇതിന്റെ വ്യക്തമായ അർത്ഥം എന്താണെന്ന് എങ്ങും എഴുതി വെച്ചിട്ടില്ല.
The true meaning of it is not clearly stated.
ചരിത്രങ്ങളിൽ നിന്നുള്ള ഊഹാപോഹങ്ങളിൽ നിന്നും അറിവുകളിൽ നിന്നും എഴുതി വെച്ച പല കാര്യങ്ങളാണല്ലോ.
Oh, it is by historical context that we can decipher what it means.
വ്യക്തമായ ഒരു ചരിത്ര രേഖയില്ല എന്താണ് ഈ ബാകായിൻ താഴ്വരയെന്ന്.
There is no clear evidence of what this valley of Baka is.
എന്നാൽ ലഭ്യമായ വിവരങ്ങളുടെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിൽ നമുക്ക് ചില ചിന്താഗതികളിലേക്ക് എത്താം.
But let us go into some of what we know.
ഇത് യോർദാനിൽ നിന്ന് ഹല്ലേലൂയ യെരുശലേമിലേക്കുള്ള യാത്രയിലെ ഒരു താഴ്ന്ന പ്രദേശമാണ്.
This is a valley in the travel from Jordan to Jerusalem.
ഈ താഴ്വരയിൽ വളരുന്ന ചില വൃക്ഷങ്ങളുണ്ട്.
There are some special trees that grow in this valley.
ഇന്ന് അവിടെ ഉണ്ടോ എന്ന് എനിക്ക് അറിയത്തില്ല.
I don't know if they are there today.
ഇത് വേദപുസ്തക കാലത്തിലെ ചരിത്രവുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട ചില വാക്കുകൾ ഓർപ്പിച്ചുവെന്ന് മാത്രം.
I'm just reminding you of what in the historical context is true.
ആ വൃക്ഷങ്ങളുടെ പേര് ബാഗ വൃക്ഷങ്ങൾ ബാൽസം ട്രീ എന്ന് പറയുന്നതാണ്.
That is called the balsam trees.
ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഒരു ഒരു കണ്ണുനീർ തുള്ളി പോലെ വെളുത്ത പശ ഇങ്ങനെ ഇറ്റിറ്റ് നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരു വൃക്ഷങ്ങളാണ് അത്.
It is a special tree that puts out a liquid that appears to be tears.
അപ്പോൾ തന്നെ വേദപുസ്തക സംഭവവുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട ഒരു ചരിത്രവും അതിനുണ്ട്.
There is also a historical background to this balsam tree.
എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഇതിനെ ബാഗ താഴ്വര എന്ന് വിളിക്കുന്നതിന്റെ ഒരു അർത്ഥം.
Why is it called the valley of Baka?
ന്യായാധിപന്മാരുടെ പുസ്തകം 2:4-5 വാക്യങ്ങൾ.
In Judges 2:4-5
ഇസ്രായേൽ അവിടെ നാം ഇങ്ങനെ വായിക്കുന്നത്.
We read there.
ഇസ്രായേൽ ഗോത്രങ്ങൾക്ക് അവകാശം ലഭിച്ചിട്ടും അവർക്ക് ലഭിച്ച അവകാശത്തിൽ കുടിയിരുന്ന ജാതികളെ അവർ പുറത്താക്കിയില്ല.
The people of Israel, even though they were given the promised land, they did not throw out the people that lived there.
അപ്പോൾ യഹോവയുടെ ഒരു ദൂതൻ അവിടെ പ്രത്യക്ഷനായി അവരോട് പറഞ്ഞു, നിങ്ങൾ ഈ ജാതികളെ നീക്കാഞ്ഞതുകൊണ്ട് അവർ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കണികളും നിങ്ങളുടെ വിലാപ്പുറത്ത് ഒരു മുള്ളുമായി മാറും.
So Israel was rebuked by the angel of the Lord for not keeping their word, and they said these people will be always a trouble for you.
ഈ സന്ദേശം കേട്ടപ്പോൾ ഇസ്രായേൽ മക്കൾ ആർത്ത് അല്ലേലൂയ കരയുവാൻ തുടങ്ങി.
The people of Israel, when they heard this news started to cry. So the name was called Bochim, or the place of weeping.
Well,
this might be that place. It might be a place with the balsam trees as well. In 2 Samuel chapter 5:24, in the battle between David and the Philistines, we know about the history that the sound of marching of the Lord in front of the people of God gave them the victory. Oh, the history of that name is not our main message. In the midst of our pain, we know a God that is with us in the valleys. Oh, as we are traveling from Jordan to Jerusalem, after going through the death Jordan, after crucifying our flesh, the children of God that are saved, that are separated and living a holy life, after getting the baptism in Jordan, after recovering the weapons of the Lord from Jordan, the saints who are breaking Jordan by the beating it with a cloth, as they are going in their travel to Jerusalem. Oh, but in the valley of Baca, oh, there is not much water to drink. There is unexpected thirst in this valley of Baca. Oh, when your lips are dry and stuck to the top of your mouth.
Oh,
when you are afraid you will be falling. Oh, when you cannot take one step forward and you are sweating. People that want to help you are in the same boat. Oh, these are going people going to Zion as well. The people who should help you cannot help you. How many times have you been in this valley? We have nothing else to do but bow our knees. We will cry in that valley. We will lament in that valley. There are tears will be like river in that valley. Oh, these are the valley of tears for the saint of God. Oh, their tongue is stuck to the top of their mouth. Oh, the children are asking for food, but there is no food to give. Oh, the people are searching. But their heart is weakened. Their eyes are quickly opened. They see small springs that are here and there. Oh, to strengthen that. The former rain of the Lord is coming down. When no one is there to help. Oh, it is blessed by the former rain of the Lord. When there was a time of death that you expected. When you said that you would wither in this place. But there is a spring of the Lord that is a help for you. I thank the Lord in the Spirit. I thank the Lord for those who have that testimony last year. Oh, the people that were in their deathbed or sick. When you cried out with tears. When the night when no one could help you. When you were in pain. Oh, as a loud thunder. Oh, the Lord sent it upon my body. Oh, the strength which is the courage of the Lord. Oh, the strength of the Lord in my heart. Oh, the rain that will strengthen me and lift me up. Oh, the strength of the Lord that makes my desires come to pass. Oh, when everything was to stop, the Lord gave a new beginning. Those who have that testimony, greater.
testimony. Oh, in a place of dry land. This is a place of desert. It is turned into a river. To come into a place where you can swim. When you could not sing one small song.
Oh,
but you sang so many songs at the end. When you said, no, it is impossible. Oh, with prayer, the Lord was able to change the atmosphere. When people said it is impossible. Oh, you were able to swim in the river of God. The Lord who turns my desert into rivers. Oh, the reason my weeping was able to turn into a blessing. Don't we need to know the four lessons I learned from this valley? Let me say that and quickly finish. What does this valley teach me? What did the rain that fell there show me? What did I learn as a lesson when my circumstances changed? The first lesson I learned,
it is temporary.
This valley of Baca is temporary. What do we read there? When you walk or when you go through the valley,
we are just passing through this valley.
This is just a place you're passing through. This is temporary. It is just there for a short while. Oh, this is a pain and tears that will be temporary. Oh, in a few moments it will go away. This pandemic will go away. This is temporary. Oh, there is joy coming in the morning. How many of you will say, oh, this is just a short period of tears. Oh, this is just to prepare me for Zion. Oh, I will not be afraid. Because the one who wipes away my tears is a God of the valley. In the life of Jesus, many people went through this valley. Hearing the voice of the leper, the Lord who cleansed him and hugged him. Oh, in our life, when your eyes is filled with guilt, there is a God who will take you back in. Oh, seeing the possession of the daughter. When the devil was constraining this young lady, the Canaanite woman who grabbed the feet of Jesus, just as she was freed and that valley was over, in the valley of tears for you. Oh, it might be about your children's future. It might be about your child's spiritual
walk.
Oh, let heavens break the bondages upon your child. Oh, the Lord is with me in this valley of Baca. Oh, it might be Bartimaeus' cry. From birth he had a blind eye. When he cried out for mercy, oh, he called them near and wiped away his tears. Just his eyes were open and he was able to see. In the midst of the valley of
Baca,
the Lord is opening some inner eyes to see some things they had never seen before. To see new revelations.
see new dreams,
to
see new experiences. Oh, the Spirit leading you in the new ways. The Lord is preparing some people in the valley of tears. Oh, with zeal you're able to worship Him. I want to go on and on. Just like the widow in the town of Nain. Oh, just like the sisters in Bethany. It may be the tears of bereavement. Oh, He will wipe your tears then. Oh, just as people were risen from death to life, there are separation of tears in our life. When people that we loved have quickly left us from earth, our heart is hardened. Oh, that is also a valley of tears. But what happens in that valley? Oh, people that are in the ground, we have a blessed hope that they will resurrect. The one who believes in me, even though dead, they shall live. Oh, when you hear that voice from the Spirit, our valley of tears will become valley of hope. Our heart is strengthened. That is the first lesson in the valley of tears. It is just temporary. The second lesson, it can turn into a blessing in our life. What do we read there? Oh, in the valley of tears they were blessed. When nothing could be gained, when everything was thought to be ending, oh, they are receiving the blessing of the Lord. Just like rain came down in a small way and it became a river. Oh, when you cry, there will be praises there. Let me go forward. The third lesson, when you go through the valley of tears, in 84 verse 6 to 7,
it makes us stronger and stronger.
It makes us stronger and stronger, it says. Oh, the valley thought it will be weakened. This will be his burial. But they were wrong. We are gaining from strength to strength. Do you know why? Oh, we know in our heart that nothing of the world can defeat us. Do you know why? There is a God in the valleys with me in my valley of tears. Oh, knowing that this God is my God forever and ever. It makes us do the miraculous. Oh, when you get that knowledge, they will lift their hands and say, they will lift the Bible in their hands and say, what can separate us from the love of Christ? Oh, Paul, who had been beaten all over his body, he had not eaten 3 square meals. He had been in a shipwreck. He had been in danger on land and the sea. He had received the Jewish beatings. He had been at the point of death. Many times he was naked. He had been thrown in front of wild lions. He had been in many places of judgment. But he says, oh, what can separate us from the love of Christ? Oh, we are more than overcomers through Christ. Count them one by one the way He has led you. In 2020, oh, March 14th, the church shut down. Now it's 54 weeks. The Lord has kept us. Oh, strength has not declined. Day by day, they are strengthened. Do you know why? Oh, no. No pandemic. Oh, no ridicule.
Oh, daily we are going from strength to strength. So Paul wrote like this. In Romans chapter
5,
in verse 3 through
5,
oh, the lessons that this valley of tears teaches us. You know this, and let me say it. When we go through tribulation, it teaches us perseverance. Oh, it gives us the strength to go overcome it. When we go through trials, it builds our character. Oh, it makes us strong in the Lord. Next it says, when we go through tribulation, through that character we get hope. Oh, the valley of tears gives us strength daily. The fourth lesson from the valley of tears, that is what we read in Psalms 84.
At the end we will reach our destiny.
At the end we will reach our destiny. We will all reach Zion and be with the Lord forever and ever. When you go through the valley of tears, there is a great joy that we receive. That is our blessed hope that we will reach our place, Zion. Oh, all the trouble that we went through. All the ridicule and mocking that we went through. All the valley of tears is for this good tomorrow. It is for this blessed hope. Oh, it is to reach this place of joy. That is why the Lord was with us in the valley of tears and helped us. So that his bride, the church, does not become weaker. I thank the Lord who comes down into our valleys. Our God is God of the valleys today as well. Oh, there are many saints of God in prison for the gospel. There are many going through the fiery furnace experience. But our God comes down in the midst of that as well. The Lord pushes us forward in the midst of every tribulation. The Lord has given a solution for every trial that he puts. Let me close my words. When I open my eyes, I see there is a day when thousands and thousands of saints wearing white will be there gathered. There is a vision that is in the eyes of the saint of God, even in the valley of tears. Oh, in Revelations it is summarized. In chapter 7, verse 9 onwards, a great multitude of saints. And people are asking, who are these people? They are wearing white. Knowing their history, they're asking, who is this? They have come from the valley of tears or the valley of Baca. Oh, they have been beaten for Christ and they have suffered ridicule. They have endured much for the gospel. Do you know why their clothes are so white? Oh, they have washed their garments in the blood of Jesus. Oh, the world might be throwing dirt at you. Oh, it might dishonor you. It will try to put dirty clothes on you. But there is a day my clothes will be washed.
Hallelujah.
The day that it will be washed and made white. Oh, countless saints coming forward. On that day, the sea will give up the dead. The rivers will give up the dead in the rivers. Oh, the dead bodies on the earth will also be risen.
വേണ്ടി ഈ അമ്പാറ്റകളെ പോലെ അഗ്നിക്കിരയായവർ ശരീരത്തിൽ കരിപുരളാത്ത തേജസ് ഉടനെറ്റു വരും.
The people who have suffered and was burned alive for Christ will also be risen.
ഓ മൃഗം പച്ചമാംസം കടിച്ചുകീറി എല്ലിൻ കഷ്ണമാക്കി മാറ്റിയ വിശുദ്ധന്മാരുടെ ശരീരം തേജസ്സോടെ ഉയർക്കും.
The saints of God that were eaten by animals will get their glorious bodies.
അന്ന് ജീവനോടെ ഭൂതലെ പാർക്കും ശുദ്ധിമാന്മാർ.
Oh, we will live and this earth.
ആഹള നാദത്തിങ്കൽ കണ്ണിമേക്കുന്ന നൊടിയിൽ രൂപാന്തര ശരീരത്തോടെ ഹല്ലേലൂയ രൂപപ്പെടൂ.
At the sound of the trumpet we will be quickened and we will receive our glorious bodies.
അങ്ങനെ നാം എല്ലാവരും സിയോനിൽ ദൈവസന്നിധിയിൽ ചെന്നെത്തും.
And we will all reach Zion in the presence of the Lord.
ഇന്ന് പകലെ എത്ര പേർക്ക് സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്?
How many of you are joyful this morning?
ഞാൻ കണ്ണുനീർ താഴ്വരയിൽ കടന്നുപോയാലും,
even though I go through the valley of tears,
നീ എന്നോട് കൂടെ ഇരിക്കുന്നുവല്ലോ.
You are with me, Lord.
നീ അതിനെ ജലാശയമാക്കി മാറ്റുന്നു.
You make it a place of water.
ഞങ്ങൾ ഈ പ്രതിസന്ധിയും കടന്നു കയറും.
Oh, we will overcome this valley.
ഞങ്ങൾ ഈ പ്രതികൂലവും കടന്നു കയറും.
We will overcome this trouble.
ഒടുവിൽ ഞങ്ങൾ നിത്യതയിലേക്ക് നടന്നു കയറും.
And in the end we will reach that place of eternity. So can you declare this morning with great joy?
ഞങ്ങൾ സേവിക്കുന്ന ദൈവം, he is the God of valleys, താഴ്വരകളുടെ ദൈവമാണ്.
My God is the God of valleys.
ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവം താഴ്വരകളുടെ ദൈവമാണ്.
My God is the God of valleys.
എത്ര പേർക്ക് സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്?
How many of you are joyful?
ആരെങ്കിലും യേശുവിനെ കണ്ടുമുട്ടിയിട്ടില്ലെങ്കിൽ,
if no one, if there is anyone that has not met Jesus,
വിശ്വാസത്തിൽ പതറി പോയിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ,
if anyone has gone wayward in the faith,
സുവിശേഷത്തിന്റെ ആത്മാവിൽ ഞങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങളോട് അറിയിക്കുന്നു,
let me tell you in the spirit of the gospel,
ഈ കഷ്ടത താൽക്കാലികമാണ്.
This pain is temporary.
ഈ നിന്ദ താൽക്കാലികമാണ്.
Oh, this ridicule is temporary.
ദൈവത്തിന്റെ കനം നമുക്കായി ഒരുക്കിയിരിക്കുന്നു.
Oh, the Lord is preparing a great glory for us.
ദൈവം നിങ്ങളെ ഈ വചനങ്ങളാൽ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ.
May the Lord bless you with these words.
മോശയാത്രയാണ് ഇത് ഞാൻ നടപ്പത്, കാഴ്ചയാലേ അല്ല വിശ്വാസത്താലെയാ. മോക്ഷയാത്രയാണിത് ഞാൻ നടപ്പത്, കാഴ്ചയാലേ അല്ല വിശ്വാസം. ഓ താഴ്ചകൾ വീഴ്ചകൾ വന്നിടും വേളയിൽ, രക്ഷകൻ കൈകളിൽ താങ്ങിടും. താഴ്ചകൾ വീഴ്ചകൾ വന്നിടും വേളയിൽ, രക്ഷകൻ കൈകളിൽ താങ്ങിടും. സിയോൻ യേശുവിൽ
കുരിശിൻ്റെ പാതയോ, സിയോൻ സഞ്ചാരി
യേശുവിൽ
ചാരി ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു.
കുരിശിൻ്റെ
പാതയിൽ
സാക്ഷികൾ
സമൂഹം എൻ്റെ ചുറ്റിലോ നിൽക്കുന്ന ആയിരങ്ങൾ,
ആകയാലിതാൻ
സാക്ഷികൾ സമൂഹം എൻ്റെ ചുറ്റിലോ നിൽക്കുന്ന ആയിരങ്ങൾ. പോകുന്നു കുരിശിൻ്റെ പാതയിൽ, സിയോൻ സഞ്ചാരി ഞാൻ യേശുവിൽ ചാരി ഞാൻ പോകുന്നു കുരിശിൻ്റെ പാതയിൽ.
നമ്മുടെ കണ്ണുകളെ അടയ്ക്കാൻ നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. സ്വർഗീയപിതാവേ, ഞങ്ങളുടെ സ്നേഹമുള്ള ദൈവമേ, വിശുദ്ധ സഭായോഗത്തിൽ പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിന്റെ സാന്നിധ്യം നിങ്ങളെ നിറച്ചല്ലോ. നല്ല പാട്ടുകൾ പാടുവാൻ സഹായിച്ചല്ലോ. ജനത്തെ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ചല്ലോ. ഞങ്ങൾ കടന്നു പോകുന്ന വൈഷമ്യമേറിയ താഴ്വരകളുടെ നടുവിൽ ദൈവം ഞങ്ങളുടെ കരം പിടിച്ചു കൂടെയുണ്ടെന്നും, ഈ താഴ്വര ഞങ്ങളുടെ അവസാനമല്ലെന്നും, ഇത് കടന്നുപോയി ഞങ്ങൾ നിത്യതുറമുഖത്തൊടുവിലെത്തുമെന്നും, ഹല്ലേലൂയ, ഇവിടെ ഞങ്ങൾ മേൽക്കുമേൽ ബലം പ്രാപിച്ച് ധൈര്യസമേതം യാത്ര ചെയ്യുമെന്നും പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാ ഞങ്ങളെ ഉത്ബോധിപ്പിച്ചല്ലോ. കൊർന്നലിയോസിന്റെ ഭവനത്തിൽ വെളിപ്പെട്ട ആത്മപ്രദർശനം ഇന്ന് പകൽക്കാലം വചന ശുശ്രൂഷയിൽ ആരുടെയൊക്കെ ഭവനത്തിൽ വെളിപ്പെടണമോ, ആത്മനിറവ് വ്യാപരിക്കണം. മുഖപക്ഷമില്ലാത്ത ദൈവസ്നേഹത്തിന്റെ അലലുയ്യ അത് അലലുയ്യ ദൂതുകൾ ജനത്തിന് മേൽ കടന്നു വരുമാറാകട്ടെ. എല്ലാവരും ക്രിസ്തുവിൽ ഒന്നാണെന്നുള്ള വലിയ സന്ദേശം ജനം അനുഭവിക്കട്ടെ. ദേശങ്ങളിലെ വിഭിന്നത മാറട്ടെ. സഭകളിലെ വിഭാഗീയത മാറട്ടെ. യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ കൽപ്പിക്കുന്നു. ഐ പി സി ഹെബ്രോൻ ഒക്ലഹോമ സഭയിലുള്ള എല്ലാ മാന്യ ദൈവദാസിദാസന്മാർക്കായി, കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾക്കായി, കുടുംബങ്ങൾക്കായി, പ്രായമുള്ള മാതാപിതാക്കൾക്കായി സ്തോത്രം. ഇന്ന് പകൽ ഞങ്ങൾ യേശുവിന്റെ നാമം ചൊല്ലി അവരെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നു. രോഗികൾ സൗഖ്യമായല്ലോ, മനം തകർന്നവരുടെ മുറിവ് കെട്ടിയല്ലോ. കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങളെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണം. എല്ലാവിധ ആശീർവാദങ്ങൾക്കായി സ്തോത്രം. യേശുവിൻ ധന്യനാമത്തിൽ തന്നെ ആമേൻ.